Looks like a commercial for the Republicans, doesn't it? However...
Oh, relax, I'm only teasing.
All right, when I tap you on the shoulder, please state your name for the folks at home.
Sue.
Sue.
Claudia.
And?
Colin.
Colin. Are you three related in any way?
We are.
Yes.
Good. Where are you from?
Australia.
I see. All three of you?
Yeah.
Which town in Australia?
The Gold Coast.
I see. Where the pirates come from. What they probably don't know is that I get into terrible trouble with the Australian press only recently for saying some naughty things about the capital city of Australia, Canberra. I'd best not tell them about that. So, have you ever been to Canberra? It's the capital city of Australia. Ever been there?
That's correct, yes. It is,
yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Nice town, is it?
It is a good town.
Is it a good town?
Mm-hmm.
I see.
Oh, my God.
What business are you in, sir?
I trade.
Ah. Trade what?
Shares.
He's a banker from the Gold Coast. A pirate. So, wait. So, what are you doing in America, you three?
Holidays.
Holidays?
Yes.
You've come to see Hollywood, no doubt.
Yes.
Are you a fan of anyone small and singy, Justin Bieber, that kind of a thing, or is that kind of behind you?
Kind of behind
yes.
me.
Yes. What are you into now, then?
Oh, gosh. Anything. Anytime...
This is the wrong time.
Not the right show, I don't think.
You don't bring your daughter here, man.
No.
Apparently she's into anything, and this is a really bad place to say stuff.
I'm starting to figure that. Yeah,
So, how long are you here for?
We've been here 4 weeks.
You've been here 4 weeks?
That's correct.
Have you seen anything exciting?
You've got me on that one.
Yeah, you're all right. Well, how long are you here for? When are you going back to Australia?
2 days' time.
Well, luckily for you, tomorrow night we're going to send you to a swanky Hollywood restaurant, aren't we?
Craig's.
Craig's? It's called Craig's, but it's nothing to do with me. It's actually good. And it is. They've got, yeah, you enjoy steaks in Australia, don't you?
We do. Yes.
They've probably got them.
Yeah.
There.
Yeah.
Right then. I think we go through that without getting in any trouble with the Canberra. When you're back in Australia, if you bump into anyone from Canberra, please offer my apologies to them.
Okay, we'll do that.
They'll know what you mean.
Ferguson, sponsored by Denny's. America's diner is always open. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
I was going to try my new thing as well, mate. Look, are you ready? They're ugly, but they're easy pleased. When I say ugly, I don't mean ugly physically. You're beautiful. I just mean ugly mentally. That's all right. I'm rather hideous myself inside. It's my new face. You like my new face? You like it? It's a great day for America, everybody. Yes, indeed. It is a great day for our friends over in Britain. They are called the British. They they won the Tour de France. The Tour de France was run by Bradley Wiggins, who won the... Yes, Bradley, which is a great name, Bradley Wiggins. That's a very English name, isn't it? Bradley Wiggins. I say, didn't you hear Bradley Wiggins has won the Tour de France? I'm jolly good. I'm sorry. Bradley Wiggins from Downton Abbey, sir? Yes. He's the first Englishman to triumph in France since Henry V opened a can of whoop-ass at Agincourt. And now, you're welcome, five people.
Agincourt? The hell is that?
In London today, thousands of Brits drank and rioted, then they heard about the Tour de France. I'd like to learn more about bicycling. I guess you could say I'm bi-curious. I'm interested. Ah, come on, that's a great joke. It is. We don't agree, but we'll applaud because we're afraid. Anyway, I'm interested in any exercise that involves a lot of sitting down. Although the real reason I don't do a lot of cycling, it makes my junk numb. No, it does. And I get enough of that from masturbating. However, I do know that whenever you're biking, the first task is safety. Did I say task?
Your first task is safety. Remember that. Pirates when bicycling, your first task is safety. Ah.
No, your task is safety. You know, you shouldn't take any chances. That's why I always wear a helmet up top and downstairs. A helmet for my helmet, if you will. And you will. A lot of these professional bikers have problem with the chafing, you know, down below. I'm not making that up. They use stuff called butt butter. No, that's what they call it, the butt butter. It prevents irritation down there. Butt butter works great, but man, does it taste awful on toast.
Spandexy.
The Tour de France is brutal, though, because, you know, unless you're the leader, you spend 3 weeks staring at some guy's sweaty ass in spandex. But there's also a downside. It's classy tonight, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, top shelf.
Aye, Mr. Wiggins. Bradley Wiggins, that's right. So, Wiggins, you won the Tour de France, did you?
In recent years, the Tour de France has been tarnished, of course, by rumours of drug use. And by rumours of drug use, I mean more drugs than the average fish concert. Last year, a top anti-doping official called the Tour de France the World Series of Steroids. And I'm like, oh, easy there, pal. There's already a World Series of Steroids. It's called the World Series. Accurate to say the Tour de France is the Super Bowl of cycling, but instead of saying, I'm going to Disney World, the winner says, Sous de l'heure, I'm going to ass my genitals. Actually, no, he wouldn't say that because he was English this year, so he would say, oh, blimey, I'm going to have to go and rub cold water on my junk.
Oh, dear, Wiggins, I say, would you give me a spot of the butt butter then?
Yeah. I'm afraid, sir, I'm going to need some butt butter. I seem to be chafed in the nether regions. Lance Armstrong, of course, who never failed a drug test, holds the record for the most, you know what I mean, he won it the most. 7 times. That's an amazing feat that will probably never be duplicated. For 7 years, he was able to restrain himself from punching French people in the face. Even more impressive, Lance raced for the US Postal Service team, which means he also had to deliver the mail en route. What was that?
What was that movie where Kevin Costner was the postman?
It was The Postman.
The Postman, yeah. Yeah. Do you ever see that movie?
Yeah. That was a great one, yeah. It's hard to get your mail in the post-apocalypse.
Yeah, no, that was the whole twist. It was the apocalypse, but it still had to deliver the mail. Like, oh, look, the Earth has been destroyed. I'll never get that letter from Clearinghouse now. Only the pirates are left. The Earth has been destroyed apart from pirates. And who can we steal stuff from? Only other pirates.
I ordered this butt butter 3 months ago.
Yeah, guy, it's taken so long to get here. It's gone orf. Oh, yeah, the Tour de France. Now, listen, I hope. What are we talking about pirates for? See, that's your fault. Look, anyway, I hope it doesn't come out that Bradley Wiggins is on steroids, because these days they don't just test for steroids, they also test for the masking agents that hide them. And he's English, so he had access to the most powerful masking agent of all, the meat pie. Not even a drug tester wants to know what's really in a meat pie. Nobody wants to know. All right, Governor, this meat pie's got, you got your horse ears, your monkey snot, blood sausage, Judy Dench's back hair, a little bit of butt butter. Anything else in your meat pie now?
Maybe some chafing flakes on top there.
Yeah, chafing flakes. You want chafing flakes on your meat pie, is that? No, I don't want any of them, because I'm a pirate. You know, sometimes I think this show's just a mockery of late-night television. A mockery.
A mockery, you say?
A mockery, I say.
No.
Yes, it's almost like we come out here with a total disregard for the format, just do any old crap we like.
Sounds like business as usual.
Yeah. All right, Jeff, me old cock sparrow. Hey, it's better than I say it that way than the other way around, right? You ready?
Yes.
Do it then.
Here we go. Tonight's program is brought to you by Wiggins Old Fashioned Butt Butter, superior on your posterior for cheeks that are cheerier.
You ready?
Yeah.
You want to try one?
Yeah.
All right. Let's check in with our overseas correspondent, Her Majesty the Queen.
I'm very excited about winning the Tour de France. In your face, bitches.
Thanks, Your Majesty.
Wow, what a treat. The Queen.
Who knew the Queen was going to be here in plate form? In plate form. The Australians would be excited. You enjoy the Queen, don't you, Australians? Yes. Did you just do a little thing for the Queen there? What time is it, Jeffrey Pierce?
It's street mail time. Time to take advice from a man who thinks 50 Shades of Grey is a topical solution for his man business.
Wait. Did you write that down or something? A learn?
Oh, that's all in here.
If I find out you've been rehearsing,
No, I would never rehearse.
Don't rehearse. I'm sorry, I'm going to have to move this plate because the Queen keeps looking at me. It's like, I keep saying, you know what I see when the plate's like that, I just, when it's looking at me, I think,
you can run, but you can't hide.
All right, play the jingle then.
Twitter. Tweeting.
Tweeting.
Ephemeral. Fleeting, Logan Webb, Face Code, Twit Zone, Ask Mode, Jigsaw Tweets,
for tweets.
Checks for tweets.
Checks for tweets.
Und also E-Mails.
E-mail time is coming down the line.
Right, Jeff?
E-mail time.
E-mail time is coming down the line. Whoa, whoa, hey! Think before you applaud. This is from Rocky in Marlborough in Massachusetts, who says, hi there, Craig. I got bad sunburn over the weekend, and nothing seems to help the itching. Any ideas? You want to get some butt butter on that? Rub it all over. What do you use for sun? Oh,
you jackass!
Yeah, come on. Do you ever get sunburned, Jeff? Do you ever?
Yeah, sure. About 400 years ago.
Jeff, have you been a skeleton robot for 400 years?
The world may never know.
This is from Jennifer in Carlsbad in California. I don't know if you can tell, but Jennifer's a cockatoo. So, Jennifer says, dear Craig, what are you going to... you know what that's called there, what I did there? You know what that is? That's tonguing the joke. You know, you hear the joke and you... Where did I learn that? Stephen Fry used to do that, I think. Was it Stephen Fry or Hugh Laurie used to talk about tonguing the joke? You ever heard that?
I think it was Stephen.
Stephen?
May have shown you that, yeah.
Hey. dear Craig, what are you going to miss most when you move to the new studio? Oh, the dampness. I'm going to miss the audience being so close. I like the intimate feel of 110 drunk hobos staring at me. Sorry. Sorry, 107 drunk hobos and 3 adorable Australians. This is from Meg in Vancouver, British Columbia. You ever been up there, British Columbia?
Oh, yeah,
got
love
a little
it up
place there.
There,
maybe, haven't you?
I got a place like to go swimming and.
You go swimming in British Columbia?
Oh, yeah,
it's cold
sure.
up there, yeah.
Yeah,
that'll,
very cold.
Dear Craig and Jeff, I've been married for 6 years, and for the last 5, my husband has woken me up every morning with his snoring. It's a terrible way to start the day. What should I do? Is snoring a Canadian word for sex? Or maybe it's a Canadian sexual technique. The two Canadian sexual techniques, snoring and apologizing. Sorry. Sorry. I'm kidding. Canadians are very sexy. What should I do about my husband snoring? Well, you could plug up his nose. Get some they've got some kangaroo testicles right here. Recognize these? You've got to get them and just stunk in his nose and he'll start. Or maybe it's if you open the nose. I don't know. Would you know anything about snoring?
How dare you?
This is from Jeremy and... I know we're done. I'll just do another couple. This is from Jeremy in Boise State University in Boise. In America. It says, hello, Craig. Any good hangover remedies? I never got a hangover. I was drunk from 1979 to 1992, and I would never got a hangover once. I just kept drinking. Keep drinking, keep drinking, keep drinking. Rehab. It's risky, but there's no hangovers. This is from Evan, who says, dear Craig, please toss this over the table on your show. Okay. That's Pavlovian, see? That was Pavlovian. The audience applauded when I threw the bit of paper, so I just kept throwing it. And now I have no paper left, but only it's only me and Her Majesty here. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Sir Jubilee this year. Come on, Jeff. We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back. My first guest tonight, a fantastic actor. He's starring in the national tour of Locajo Fall. And the next stops are at Costa Mesa and San Diego. Costa Mesa and San Diego. Please welcome the delightful George Hamilton, everybody. George Hamilton.
That's like my mind. That's the way I feel.
Oh,
like
calm it. Now. Your oh, mind's tidier than that.
Did I hear that Bradley Wiggins won the Tour de France?
Bradley Wiggins won the Tour de France. Isn't that jolly good?
If we were in the ball all night. I've been on steroids with them all day.
No, calm down. You're not on steroids. You look great, though.
If I could get it, I'd take it.
What, steroids?
Well, I've never in my life worked this hard. I'm not meant to work like this.
I think of you as being someone who lives a kind of relaxed, kind of maybe go to a casino every now and again.
Yeah, and run a line of girls.
Have you become a Crip recently, George? Oh.
The audience is here.
Yeah.
Audience here. I thought that was all canned. I didn't think you had a real audience.
No, wait. You've been on the show half a dozen times.
Now, but I was stoned all that time. I never knew. I never knew the audience. They're really laughing.
Yeah. Well, some of them are laughing.
You may have to come out the airport. I haven't landed yet.
Are you in a lot of drugs?
Not yet.
Okay.
But later. I don't want to tell you, but I'm not supposed to, but I took a particular drink, a concoction that's sold in lots of bars, and they add a little vodka in it, and, you know.
Oh,
you know
it's the sort of a scarlet cow. Sort of.
That does have a... Yes, if you don't
scarlet
want to get...
Scarlet cow.
Yeah, I kind of got
yeah.
that.
Yes.
Well, all I can now, right now, I can't make a fist and my teeth have gone soft.
Man, I got to try some of that. Well, I thought that was it. Well, you don't want to take that. That's make you buzzy.
No, Mitchum.
Not a nice cup of coffee.
Mitchum used to drink things, and he'd say, "I know the line. I'm just too drunk to say it."
Either way. Did you know Robert Mitchum?
I work with him. Oh, I work with him. I got Mother's Day cards from him every year. I don't know what I'm saying. Take me back to rehab.
No, you look great though. You look fantastic. I really like this look. I'm gonna go with this. I'm getting rid of the vest.
No, I like this. I was just thinking very few people have the ability to look like that Fulton and Mason.
You sort of British look. I look like a sort of English creepy man.
No, but you know what I love about it is the stripes are all, but the tie's sort of a bit askew.
Yes, well, that's my thing, you know.
I sort of did that as well. Didn't quite have the same ring, does it?
You want to do that? Fly right back a little. I say, shall we go up in the old...
This drink is rather quick, isn't it?
Yeah. What speeds we're traveling at, George?
Look here what's going on, dear fella.
Stop, George, stop!
Bradley Wiggins is in
Bradley
the front.
Wiggins,
look,
yes!
Here he comes. I don't know what possessed me. I swear, I did have steroids once.
Did you really?
Yes, I had them while I was doing Dancing with the Stars. The doctor said, "There's no way you'll get through this. We'll have," and I'm 72 now, and it was about 65. And when Jerry Rice, who was then the best wide receiver ever, was complaining about his knee and his back,
right?
We were head-on-head competition.
Yes.
I decided I better do something. The doctor said, "Well, we just have to fix your knee. That's the only thing we can do about that." Minute I got the steroids, I thought, "Well, I'd be disqualified for this."
It's not a sporting event.
But that's what I don't know. You know,
it's not like the International Olympic Committee is going to go, "I'm sorry, George, we are stripping you of your trophy for this foxtrot."
But what did happen was that they gave me the steroids, and the only thing I could think about was mounting Stacy Keibler. But then again,
well, that's funny. I haven't taken steroids, and that's all I can think about anyway.
Well, I'm hoping the same feeling is mutual with George Clooney, since he now has Stacy Keibler, and I never, that was just an old man's dream at the time.
Oh, come on, you're not an old man. You're a dashing debonair. You know what you remind me of? You're a bit like the real version of the most interesting man in the world. Do you know the guy that...
I swear that I love that, and people have said that, especially my girlfriend late at night.
Is your are you still seeing that dermatologist?
Yeah, well, it's she's incredible. I mean, believe me, after a night of wild, you know,
card playing.
Yeah. I'll get up in the morning and I'm a bit askew. You wouldn't think that. I mean, there's something about me that's all put together.
Don't do that. You're
no, but look,
freaking
look,
me
see,
out.
Yeah. See, my hair is so trained, it goes right back in the same position.
Well, actually, it's still a bit rakish.
Oh, no, it is.
All right. There you go.
But she will then say, hold it just a moment. And she's a dermatologist. And she'll pull out her little needle and she said, just give you a little Botox right there. Then you look good again. So every day I have like a no reality check, but I do have a little check to see if I'm doing well. And it's wonderful. Why not have a wife or a girlfriend that isn't, you know, can give you Botox? That's the real thing you need when you get older. You need Botox, a wheelchair, and some of that concoction I just drank before I got here. That Bradley Wiggins won the Tour de France with.
You know, I have to tell you, you really are the most interesting man in the world. What a fascinating idea.
Yes, sir.
Hire someone who will look after you medically.
Well,
we're not hiring her, of course. Sure.
No, she would never do it. We
do it for
money.
Yes.
But the point of it is that there was either that or rich, wealthy, older woman, and the choice came down to a young, beautiful dermatologist who can shoot you up. And I mean right here. You see this?
Can I touch it?
No, go ahead. It's wax, but it'll come off in your hand. Can you make bigger circles? It's your first job, is it?
I haven't done this since I talked to an Australian barmaid. well, it feels perfectly normal.
It's like normal skin, isn't it?
You don't really have anything.
No, it's truth of the matter. I don't have any liquid or anything there.
Right.
This is all mine. This is me.
Right.
I mean,
thought I recognized you when you came out.
They have been, you know, little chains for drawbridges and lifts. But I haven't had as much work as the theater I'm in now, right? The Pantages with the Casual Fall.
Oh, yeah, nice. Yeah. I want to talk to you about the Casual Fall, really. But I have to do a commercial first. Well, I'm not doing it. Some other people are doing it.
It happens like that.
Yeah.
Yes.
But when we go back, we'll be talking about the Casual Fall. We're talking about Le Casual Fall. We were going to talk about it before the commercial break. Then we talked about it during the commercial break, and we're all done.
Oh, it's better. I'm in yet another place somewhere else.
No. Tell me about it. That's the one where you... Do you dress up as a lady?
No. I'm just a plain, one plain homosexual. I'm not a transvestite. That would be the difference, Greg, a transvestite.
Oh,
Jeff,
so you
is that the right thing? Am I correct in
that? Yeah, you got it. That's right. Yeah.
You have a place there, don't you?
I do. Great dinner party last night. Thanks.
No, wait. You play the... in the movie, Robin Williams played that character.
Birdcage. Exactly right.
Right.
Because people don't know how to say the name. Does anyone know how to say that name?
Well, Le Casual Fall?
Yeah.
Le Casual Fall.
I'm trying to get them to do
it. Most of these people don't speak English. What the hell is wrong with you? Although, I have to say, I know that Le Casual Fall is French, but they don't speak French either.
But you listen, I've been out in Iowa, and you ask them, they say, La Cajafalas.
Cajafalas?
Yeah.
I like that.
La Cajafalas.
La Cajuxfalas.
That's it.
Yeah.
So you have to say birdcage, which brings them back to still a tongue stumper.
A tongue stumper? yes, is that a thing, a tongue stumper?
What was that?
Ay, caramba!
That you were doing.
Yeah. No. Listen, we're out of time. Do you want some money?
Yeah.
Okay. $50.
That's for me?
Yep.
That's all I'm going to get? Oh, that's good.
Yeah. Hold that.
That's probably
that takes
the most...
That you back a bit, doesn't it? Yeah. Take you back to the old days, doesn't
yeah.
it?
Hey. Pirates boot.
Yeah.
I like this. And this is in quarters or something?
Yeah, it's in quarters. They help you with parking.
Well, you know, I did pay a debt off once in pennies, and I was so upset being, you know, I had to pay alimony, so I decided to put it in molasses.
You can't pay people in syrup, George. That's not acceptable currency.
My ex-wife tried so hard to get those pennies into dollars, and she finally decided the only thing to do is have them steam cleaned.
You ever had your penny steam cleaned, George?
For a penny.
Yeah. Me too. We got to go. George Hamilton, we'll be right back. Every now. Welcome back to the show. It's got a bit like Porky Pig a little bit, isn't it? It's this. You know what it is? It's the vests. Yeah, it's making me, as I say, it's making me talk like a cartoon character. My next guest is a very beautiful, I say, she's a very beautiful actress. She stars on Dallas, which airs Wednesdays on the TNT network. Take a look at this.
What part of get the hell out of here don't you understand?
Oh, come on. I know my little performance for Anne was impressive, but you didn't think I'd gone for good, did you?
I gave you those rings, and I meant what I said. We're done, Tommy.
Yeah, about your little proposal. I don't accept it.
Yeah, well, you don't have a choice. I won't be a part of this anymore. I'm pregnant, and I need to make my relationship with Christopher work.
Whoa, that's a lot of plot right there. What the hell happened? She's pregnant. She gave away the ring. She's the plot. What the hell happens now? Please welcome Julie Gonzalo, everybody. Julie Gonzalo. Welcome, Julie. Welcome.
Thank you.
Lovely to see. May I say how enchanting you look this evening?
Well, thank you. Well, I had to because you are my first late night show.
Well, this isn't really a late night show. This is just kind of like a creepy guy in a basement on cable access.
Even better. Even better. No, I've never actually. Well, we've been doing a lot of promotions for the show, but it's never been by myself. Oh. So this is nice.
Well, you're not by yourself now.
No, I'm with you.
You're with me. Yeah. I'm your friend. Jeff's your friend.
Yes. Bad guy. Amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, listen, so you're pregnant? You have to repair your relationship with Christopher? You've given the rigs away? What the hell?
Yeah, there's a lot of drama going on. But, yeah, I'm pregnant. I was actually surprised when I read it, too, because I'm like, oh, man, do I have to wear...
Yeah, you're going to have to go through the whole thing.
And then
next season it'll be... Bring in the other one because you can't use just one baby.
I know. Well, actually, I'm pregnant with twins, so we need four.
Nah. Really?
Yeah.
They probably just make animatronic babies.
No, who knows? Who knows? Do you imagine? Actually, they do that.
Yeah. What you do is they give you false arms, like a magician's arms, and then you get like puppet babies. And so they false arms around the baby like that, and then you go.
Yeah. And that you go,
oh,
that could
the babies
be
are
really
fine,
creepy.
And I have to do the rigs.
Very creepy. Very. But yeah. But I don't know.
Listen, write that down.
Yeah.
That'd be a great prop for us.
Scary, Rob.
Well, you know. Now, where are you from originally? Not Dallas, not Texas.
No, I'm from Argentina originally. I was born in Buenos Aires.
I want to go to Argentina very much. Yes, I've become fascinated with Argentina very recently. I would like... Oh, grow up.
It's a fascinating country.
Yeah, I didn't mean right. Well, I suppose that, yeah. No, I have become rather interested in it, and I want to go to Buenos Aires. I kind of fancy all that.
That's nice. Actually, I'm probably going to Scotland, so there we go.
Can I stay in your house then?
I don't have a house there, but I could give you the name of an uncle, maybe.
Okay, and I'll give you the name of my uncle in Scotland.
Is it your
very
creepy
happy
uncle?
To see you. Yeah.
Fantastic.
Oh, thanks, Craig.
Awesome.
No.
Let's do that.
You are going to Scotland?
Well, yeah, because Channel 5 was from England. They were really nice, and they're going to send us out there to do a Dallas whole
premiere. Oh, is that where the show
premiere
is on?
Huh? Well, because apparently it was bigger in England than it was here.
It was huge. People were walking around with cowboy hats on.
Yeah.
Ridiculous.
Yeah, they even have a song that goes with the theme of the show, which
really?
I don't know. I don't really know. But
don't sing it. We can't afford that.
Oh, I could never even.
You don't sing?
No. Well, not good, but yes.
But you're Argentinian, don't you? Oh, no, tango.
That makes sense.
Well, a lot of Argentinians sing. Evita?
Sure. I don't think the actual Evita sang, though.
She might have sung a little bit.
Probably in the bathroom.
You know,
yeah.
When she was like, you know, just, don't cry for me, Argentina.
Again, I don't really know. But
no,
maybe probably not. But no, but they were very kind, and they're sending us out there for a premiere and a junket and all that stuff. So I'm gonna extend another week and go to Scotland.
Oh, good for you.
Yeah.
Well, they'll like you up there.
Oh, good.
Mm. Yeah. What are you going to do up there? Do you enjoy...
I have no idea. I don't even know where to go.
Do you like drinking?
Yeah. Yeah, drinking.
Yeah,
I'm gonna try to bring a couple of friends, so then, you know, drinking becomes even bigger and better.
Oh, you'll make friends.
Oh, I know. I'm excited.
You'll make friends.
I do like to make friends. I do like to do that. So.
Well, do you like to go to the pubs?
Yeah.
Haunted pubs?
Even better. There's one right here in Hollywood.
A haunted pub?
Yeah.
What's it called?
Oh, crap. I don't remember. But I'll let you know.
It's a real pub, then.
Yeah. I was so wasted when I left. Yeah. I think
it was haunted.
Yeah,
he said he was a ghost.
Yeah. I didn't even feel him. What?
No. So, do you ever go back to Argentina?
Oh, no. Last time I was there, it was probably 10 years ago.
Well,
I was
going back, though.
I used to go back a lot when I was a child, you know, with my parents back and forth. But now...
I do fancy it. I do. I think it might be a good trip for us, you know, Buenos Aires.
I think I'm not
saying it properly, am I?
Buenos Aires.
That's how I said it. Buenos Aires.
Yeah, that's better. That's great.
Yeah.
No, that's
and
good.
I'd quite like to go to Uruguay. That's close by, isn't it? That's just
right
like over the river.
Door. Yep. Yeah. Right over the river. The widest river in the world.
The
widest, yes.
Widest or whitest?
Widest.
Widest, yeah.
Yes. And also we have the widest street in the world.
Is it near the river?
In Buenos Aires. maybe.
Wait, how do you know it's the widest street in the world? What kind of claim is that to make, anyway?
I don't know. I read it somewhere, and I thought we were cool.
Yeah, it was like, we have the widest street in the world?
Yeah.
I wanted to go there, but now you've put me off.
But you have to go.
Dangerous crossing the road.
Probably.
I can't cross roads that are that wide.
Probably.
I can get mown down halfway across.
Well, you should look both ways before crossing the street.
In a street that wide, you have to keep looking at
it. Because there's 18 lanes.
Oh.
Literally. There's nine and...
That's too wide
it
for
is
me.
Bit,
I didn't know the streets
wide.
Were that... I didn't know the streets were that wide. I've changed my mind.
Screw it.
You won't like it in Scotland then, because there's very narrow streets there.
Or I know.
You have to walk down them in single file.
Oh, really?
Yes.
And also, like, in the sidewalks. Now, wait, let me ask you. In Scotland, do they drive... like? Is it like England? Do they drive on the other side of the road? Because I'm not sure.
Yes, they drive on the... I can never remember. Look, here's the rule when driving in a foreign country, right? Keep the steering wheel in the car to the center of the road.
Okay.
And you'll be all right.
Perfect.
Yeah, keep that. And if it's the steering wheel's the wrong way around, you'll die.
Yeah, that's good. Note to self.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because I thought about driving from London to, you know, up the countryside.
It's not a picturesque drive. Oh, it's freeway all the way.
Well, I think I would die right off, like, the gate, just because I,
well,
you know.
If you're not used to the tiny little freeways of Britain,
obviously.
You're used to the giant wide streets, yeah.
Yeah, I was spoiled. But I also am really bad at driving stick shift and, you know, and you add the driving on the other side of the car.
They have automatic cars.
Oh, do they?
Queen drives on stick shift.
Does she drive?
Yeah, of course she drives. She drives all the time. She's got corgis. She drives around little corgi dogs, and she drives around.
But
and
I would assume.
Opens
I don't know. I would assume. I guess you're right. I would assume it was all stick shift. But hey, it's fine.
It's mostly stick shift.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah.
Is that a sex thing?
Could be.
Yeah. All right. We're out of time.
Okay.
You want some money?
Yeah, that'd be great. Are you giving it? Oh, you're giving up. That's good. Thank you.
I used to ask questions for it, but then I was told that I have to follow the gaming laws. So I said, all right, I'll just give it away. And they went, well, that's not a competition. I went, then get out of my cracking office. I think we learned something about kangaroos tonight, didn't we? The kangaroo landed on the cat, and due to cats being so clever, the cat found its way out. Through the pouch. Classy show on late night, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow. Good night. Good night. In London today, thousands of Brits drank and rioted. Then they heard about the Tour de France. I'd like to learn more about bicycling. I guess you could say I'm bi-curious. I'm interested. We don't agree, but we'll applaud because we're afraid. Anyway, I'm interested in any exercise that involves a lot of sitting down. Although the real reason I don't do a lot of cycling, it makes my junk numb. No, it does, and I get enough of that from masturbating. However, I do know that whenever you're biking, the first task is safety. Did I say task?
Your first task is safety. Remember that. Pirates, when bicycling, your first task is safety. Ah.
No, your task is safety. You know, you shouldn't take any chances. That's why I always wear a helmet up top and downstairs. A helmet for my helmet, if you will. And you will. A lot of these professional bikers have problem with the chafing, you know, down below. I'm not making that up. They use stuff called butt butter. No, that's what they call it, the butt butter. It prevents irritation down there. Butt butter works great, but man, does it taste awful on toast. Spandexy. The Tour de France is brutal, though, because, you know, unless you're the leader, you spend 3 weeks staring at some guy's sweaty ass in spandex. But there's also a downside. It's classy tonight, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, top shelf.
Aye, Mr. Wiggins.
Bradley Wiggins, that's right. So, Wiggins, you won the Tour de France, did you? In recent years, the Tour de France has been tarnished, of course, by rumours of drug use. And by rumours of drug use, I mean more drugs than the average fish concert. Last year, a top anti-doping official called the Tour de France the World Series of Steroids. And I'm like, oh, easy there, pal. There's already a World Series of Steroids. It's called the World Series. Accurate to say the Tour de France is the Super Bowl of cycling, but instead of saying, I'm going to Disney World, the winner says, Sous de l'or, I'm going to ask my genitals. Actually, no, he wouldn't say that because he was English this year, so he would say, oh, blimey, I'm going to have to go and rub cold water on my junk.
Oh, dear, Wiggins, I say, would you give me a spot of the butt butter then?
Yeah, I'm afraid. Offer my apologies to them.
Okay, we'll do that.
They'll know what you mean.
Sponsored by Denny's. America's Diner is always open. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
I was going to try my new thing as well, mate. Look, are you ready? They're ugly, but they're easy pleased. When I say ugly, I don't mean ugly physically. You're beautiful. I just mean ugly mentally. That's all right. I'm rather hideous myself inside. It's my new face. You like my new face? You like it? It's a great day for America, everybody. Yes, indeed. It is a great day for our friends over in Britain. They are called the British. They won the Tour de France. The Tour de France was run by Bradley Wiggins, who won the... Yes, Bradley. Which is a great name, Bradley Wiggins. That's a very English name, isn't it? Bradley Wiggins. I say, did you hear Bradley Wiggins has won the Tour de France? I'm jolly good. I'm sorry. Bradley Wiggins from Downton Abbey, sir? Yes. He's the first Englishman to triumph in France since Henry V opened a can of whoop-ass at Agincourt. And now, you're welcome, five people.
Agincourt? The hell is that?
Looks like a commercial for the Republicans, doesn't it? However...
Oh, relax, I'm only teasing.
All right, when I tap you on the shoulder, please state your name for the folks at home.
Sue.
Sue.
Claudia.
And?
Colin.
Colin. Are you three related in any way?
We are.
Yes.
Good. Where are you from?
Australia.
I see. All three of you?
Yeah.
Which town in Australia?
The Gold Coast.
I see. Where the pirates come from. What they probably don't know is that I get into terrible trouble with the Australian press only recently for saying some naughty things about the capital city of Australia, Canberra. I'd best not tell them about that. So, have you ever been to Canberra? It's the capital city of Australia. Ever been there?
That's yes. Correct, it is, yes.
Yeah. Nice town, is it?
It is a good town.
Is it a good town?
Mm-hmm.
I see. What business are you in, sir?
I trade.
Ah. Trade what?
Shares.
He's a banker from the Gold Coast. A pirate. So, what are you doing in America, you three?
Holidays.
Holidays?
Yes.
You've come to see Hollywood, no doubt.
Yes.
Are you a fan of anyone small and singy, Justin Bieber, that kind of a thing, or is that kind of behind you?
Kind of behind
me. Yes. What are you into now, then?
Oh, gosh. Anything.
This is the wrong time.
Not the right show, I don't think.
You don't bring your daughter here, man.
No.
Apparently she's into anything, and this is a really bad place to say stuff.
I'm starting to figure that out.
So, how long are you here for?
We've been here 4 weeks.
You've been here 4 weeks?
That's correct.
Have you seen anything exciting?
You've got me on that one.
Yeah, you're all right. Well, how long are you here for? When are you going back to Australia?
2 days' time.
Well, luckily for you, tomorrow night we're going to send you to a swanky Hollywood restaurant, aren't we?
Great.
Craig's? It's called Craig's, but it's nothing to do with me. It's actually good. And it is. They've got... Yeah, you enjoy steaks in Australia, don't you?
We do. Yes.
They've probably got them there.
Yeah.
Right, then. I think we go through that without getting in any trouble with the Canberra. When you're back in Australia, if you bump into anyone from Canberra, please... Hey, it's better than I say it that way than the other way around, right? You ready?
Yes.
Do it then.
Here we go. Tonight's program is brought to you by Wiggins Old Fashioned Butt Butter, superior on your posterior for cheeks that are cheerier.
You ready? You ready?
Yeah, yeah.
You want to try one?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
check in with our overseas correspondent, Her Majesty the Queen.
I'm very excited about winning the Tour de France. In your face, bitches.
Thanks, Your Majesty.
Wow, what a treat. The Queen.
Who knew the Queen was going to be here in plate form? In plate form. The Australians would be excited. You enjoy the Queen, don't you, Australians? Yes. Did you just do a little thing for the Queen there? What time is it, Jeffrey Pierce?
It's street mail time. Time to take advice from a man who thinks 50 Shades of Grey is a topical solution for his man business.
Wait. Did you write that down or something? A letter?
Oh, that's all in here.
If I find out you've been rehearsing, I...
No, I would never rehearse.
Don't rehearse. I'm sorry, I'm going to have to move this plate because the Queen keeps looking at me. It's like, I keep saying... You know what I see when the plate's like that? I just, when it's looking at me, I think... You can run, but you can't hide. All right, play the jingle then.
Twitter, tweeting, ephemeral, fleeting, Lugan web, face code, Twitzel, ass mode, jigs a tweets.
And also emails. Email time is coming down the line. Right, Jeff?
Email time is coming down the line.
Whoa, hey! Think before you applaud. I'm sorry, I'm going to need some butt butter. I seem to be chafed in the nether regions. Lance Armstrong, of course, who never failed a drug test, holds the record for the most, you know what I mean, he won it the most. 7 times. That's an amazing feat that will probably never be duplicated. For 7 years, he was able to restrain himself from punching French people in the face. Even more impressive, Lance raced for the US Postal Service team, which means he also had to deliver the mail en route. What was that movie where Kevin Costner was the postman?
It was The Postman.
The Postman, yeah. Do you ever see that movie?
Yeah, that was a great one, yeah. it's hard to get your mail in the post-apocalypse.
Yeah, no, that was the whole twist. It was the apocalypse, but they still had to deliver the mail. Like, oh, look, the Earth has been destroyed. I'll never get that letter from Clearinghouse now. Only the pirates are left. The Earth has been destroyed apart from pirates. And who can we steal stuff from? Only other pirates.
I ordered this butt butter 3 months ago.
Yeah, Kat, it's taken so long to get here. It's gone orf. Oh, yeah, the Tour de France. Now, listen, I hope... What are we talking about pirates for? See, that's your fault. Look, anyway, I hope it doesn't come out that Bradley Wiggins is on steroids, because these days they don't just test for steroids, they also test for the masking agents that hide them. And he's English, so he had access to the most powerful masking agent of all, the meat pie. Not even a drug tester wants to know what's really in a meat pie. Nobody wants to know. Well, I've noticed meat pies. You got your horse ears, your monkey snot, blood sausage, Judy Dench's back hair, little bit of butter. Anything else in your meat pie there?
Maybe some chafing flakes on top there.
Yeah, chafing flakes. You want chafing flakes on your meat pie, is that? No, I don't want any of them, because I'm a pirate. You know, sometimes I think this show's just a mockery of late-night television. A mockery!
A mockery, you say?
A mockery, I say?
No.
Yes, it's almost like we come out here with a total disregard for the format, just do any old crap we like.
Sounds like business as usual.
Yeah. All right, Jeffy. All right, Jeff, me old cock sparrow.